The world record for Formula One pit stops is a blistering 1.82 seconds by Red Bull in 2019. And here it is. This is Aliens in the Paddock. Let's talk about that. There's a lot to get done in such a short amount of time, and with no margin of error. A small mistake by the team can result in a DNF or an incredibly dangerous scenario on track. During an F1 pit stop, a flurry of coordinated activities take place within a tight time frame to optimize the car's on-track performance. So I'm going to break down everything that happens in a pit stop. Number one, as the car approaches the pit lane, the team readies their equipment, which includes specialized tools, tires. Each team member has a specific role and responsibility, and they practice extensively to ensure a silky smooth execution. Obviously, having everything ready for when the car arrives is pivotal in a great execution of a pit stop. Number two, the driver enters the box and parks the car precisely within the designated area. Number three, tire changes. The pit crew's primary task is to change the car's tires quickly. Typically, four new tires are prepared in advance and each wheel is secured with a high-speed pneumatic tool. Old tires are quickly removed and replaced to ensure optimal grip and performance. There are three people designated to each wheel of the car, one to remove an old tire, one to operate the pneumatic tool that loosens and tightens the nut holding the wheel in place, and one to drop in a new tire. That's 12 people specifically there just to work on the tires. Number four, fueling. Refueling during a race is currently prohibited, so fueling is not a part of the pit stop. However, I have read a few reports saying that fuel checks still take place. I'm not really sure about this as I couldn't find any evidence of that happening, but if you know about it, please let me know in the comments below. So yeah, refueling doesn't happen in pit stops anymore, but it used to be a critical part of Formula One strategy in years gone by. Okay, number five, adjustments and repairs. While the tire change is happening, the pit crew may also make minor adjustments to the car. This can include altering the front wing angle, tweaking the suspension, or addressing any mechanical issues that may have arisen during the race. Of course, whole pieces of the car can be replaced if required, drastically increasing pit time. Number six is communication. Throughout the pit stop, communication between the driver and the team is critical. The team's engineers and strategists analyze real-time data such as tire wear, fuel consumption, and competitor positions. They relay this information to the driver, who may provide feedback or make requests for specific adjustments. Number seven, pit stop duration. The entire pit stop process from car entering the pit lane to its departure is usually completed in under 3 seconds. Teams aim to achieve a sub 2 second pit stop, with the current record standing at 1.82 seconds, showcasing the incredible speed and precision involved. Okay, number eight, there are significant safety precautions during a pit stop. Pit stops demand exceptional safety measures. The pit crew members wear fire-resistant clothing, helmets, and gloves. The car's engine must be switched off during the stop, and any hot components, such as brakes or exhaust, are to be avoided to prevent burns or accidents. Last but not least, number nine is the exit strategy for a pit stop. Once the pit stop is complete, the team signals the driver to exit the pit box and rejoin the race. The driver accelerates back onto the track, taking care to not exceed the pit lane speed limit. After a pit happens, there is a pit stop analysis. The team evaluates performance, analyzing the efficiency of the tire changes, adjustments made, and overall time spent in the pit lane. This assessment helps in refining future pit stop strategies and improving team coordination. There are speed limitations to how fast an F1 car can travel in the pit lane. So along with the actual changing of tires and car bodyworks, the whole pit stop excursion for the car should be sub 30 seconds. It changes a little bit from track to track. Flawless pit stop execution is just as important as on-track execution of things like DRS, which is a critical component to a good race strategy. So to continue learning about every aspect of an F1 race, watch my DRS video here. Thanks for watching. Make sure you subscribe so you don't miss any of my videos. Comment down below if your thumbs are bored. This is Aliens in the Paddock. See you next time.